Okay, so here's a lesson for the Stairway to Heaven guitar solo. So if you would like to learn the solo that is strictly forbidden down in your local music store, you should stay tuned. If you would like to see my cover of this solo, you could click the link below in the description. And it will take you to a very, very old video. One of the first covers I made, I think it's 12 years ago or something like that. Well, I will divide the solo into sections. And the first section, or the first part, goes like this. Yes. We start off by doing a full bend on the G string, 7th fret. Then we pick 5 on the E string. We pick 7 on the B string, sorry, 8 on the B string, and pull off to 5. Then we pick 7 on the G string and pull off to 5. Then we pick 7 on the D string and 7 on the G string. Pull off to 5 on the G string. Then we pick 7 on the D string, we pick 5 on the D string, and slide back to 3 on the D string, or pick it, I can't remember. I think I slide back, perhaps it's more correct to pick it, but... Then we go to the B string in the 8th fret and do a full bend. Pick 8 on the E string twice. Then do a full bend on the E string 8 in the 8th fret. Pick it again and release. Now we have to do the same note 3 times, which is actually this on the 5th fret of the E string. But instead of doing this, we do this. Pick it twice. And instead of picking it the third time, you pick 8 on the B string and do a slide up to 10. Okay. And the last thing from this part is to pick 8 on the E string, pick 10 on the E string, pull off back to 8, pick 10 on the B string and pull off to 8. Pick 10 on the G string, pick 8 on the B string and hammer on to 10. Sorry. So the whole section. Okay. Yeah. The next part goes like this. Yeah, we start off by doing something almost identical to the start of the solo. So, do a full bend on the seventh fret of the G string. Pick 5 on the E string, 8 on the B string, and pull off to 5. Then 7 on the G string and pull off to 5. Pick 7 on the D string and 7 on the G string. Pull off to 5. Pick 7 on the D string and pull off to 5. 7 on the A string. 5 on the D string. Then 7 on the D string. A short note there. And then 5 on the G string. Back to 7 on the D string, and finish off with 2 the G string 5th fret twice. Pick G string loose, no fingers, and then once again 5 on the E string, 8 on the B string, pull off to 5, then 7 on the G string and pull off to 5. And 7 on the D string, 7 on the G string, pull off to 5. So. Pick 7 on the D string and pull off to 5. Repeat that. So. And slide back to 3rd fret of the D string. Okay, now we do a slide from the 5th to the 7th fret of the D string. A quick slide, not like this, but like this. Then we pick 5 on the G string, 6 on the B string, so. Pick 7 on the G string and pull off to 5. Pick 7 on the D string and 5 on the G string. We slide once again, this time on the G string, from the 7th to the 9th fret. This time not fast, not like this, but like this. So. Sorry. Okay. Then we pick H on the B string and 9 on the G string, 8 on the B string once again, and slide to 10. Okay. Then we pick 8 on the E string, and then we do a full bend on the E string in the 10th fret. And while holding this bend, we pick it again and do a quick release and a pull off to 8 on the E string. Let's see. And then once again pick 10 on the E string and pull off to 8. Go to the 15th fret of the E string and do a full bend. Pick it again and release. Pull off to 13. And do a bend on the 15th fret of the B string. And release. And pick 13 on the B string. 14 on the G string. Back to 13 on the B string. Okay. Oh, that was, so is this, I think this is a long section, but let's see. We've done this. No, sorry, we did this. The final part goes like this. Okay, so we have just done this in the previous part. So we have just picked 13 on the B string, and I think this repetitive thing. I think I do it not exactly as it should be done. I think you should pick every time. But I hammer on instead. So we've just picked this one in the previous part, 13 on the B string. Then I hammer on to 15 and do a full bend and release. So and pull off to 13. Okay. Then pick 14 on the G string and 13 on the B string. And from now on, we just repeat this 10 times. So this is one cyclus. So 1, 2, 3. Sorry, I lost track. It's very hard for me to count it, and it's not necessary to count it if you're playing on a backing track or the chord progression. It's obvious when to stop this repetitive cycle. But 10 times. I think this was 10 times. After you've done 10 times, you pick 15 on the E string and do a full bend. Pick it again and do a release. And pick 12 on the E string. Pick 15 on the B string. 12 on the E string. Pick 15 on the B string again. Pull off to 13. Pick 14 on the G string. So. Pick 13 on the B string, hammer on to 15, pull off to 13, and pick 14 on the G string. Yeah, and 13 on the B string. Okay, and then we do a full bend on 15. And while holding this bend, you pick 15 on the E string. Go back and pick the bended note and do a quick release. Pull off to 13 and pick 14 on the G string. Okay, so let's see. Yeah. Okay. For the next part, we're going up to, 15, 17, to the 19th fret of the G string. Do a full bend. Pick 20 on the B string. And pick 17 on the E string. Okay? And then go back to 20 on the B string. Pull off to 17. So I think I pick this one. You could do whatever you like. I think I pick it. And then go to the 19th fret of the G string. Do a little bend. And release. And pull off to 17, okay? Then go back to 19 on the G string, pick it, pull off to 17, go to 19 on the D string, and go to pick 17 on the G string, pick 19 on the G string, and bend it, full bend. Okay, so. Go to the 14th fret of the G string. This is this bend is more than a full bend. It's three semitone, one and a half step. I think this is correct to say. So you aim for this note. Okay. So do a bend it and. You release it a little, but then you pick it again and do this one and a half step bend once again. So. And cut it off there. So. And then pick it and do a quick release. Pick 12 on G string. Pick 14 on the G string, pull off to 12, and bend, full bend. So. Oh, sorry, this is wrong. Okay. So this next bend, once again, I'm not sure if this is exactly like on the original, but I tend to do a pretty big bend here. I bend the G string in the 9th fret, but I'm aiming for this tone, this note. The 14th fret, this, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 semitones, 2 and a half step bend. If it's not possible for you to do this bend, I guess you could also just bend a full step from the 12th fret of on the G string. But I like this, the sound of this monster bend. So I release it, and then I pick 10 on the G string, 9 on the G string, 7 on the G string. So. Then 10 on the D string. 7 on the, sorry, yeah, 10 on the D string and 7 on the G string. And back to 10 on the D string. And once again, 7 on the G string. So. Then hammer on to 9 on the G string. And pull off back to 7. Pick 10 on the D string and finish off by picking 7 on the D string. Okay, the final lick which ends this solo is once again something that repeats. Just 5 times this time. This it goes like this. So, I bar with my this finger across the 17th fret of the B and the E string. Then I pick the B string in the 7th 17th fret. Then I pick 20 on the E string, pull off to 17. So that's one cyclus. We have to do this 5 times. And then we finish up off with a full bend on the E string, 20th fret. Okay, so that's about it. So where did we start? Yes, that's it. So I hope that it has been useful for some of you guys or girls. And once again, if you would like me to do another lesson or tutorial on another solo or riff, just write it in the comment section. Bye.